About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host. And this evening, we're going to be talking about the annual point show, which is coming up September the 15th. So my guests are Al Staudt to my right with the little chin that you saw to begin with. He is our show chairman. Next to me on my left is Sally Birgl. She has a Vishla and she is our obedience chairperson. And next to her is Kandy Boll, and she's got a Pembroke Corgi, which just jumped up on her lap. And she is our assistant show chair. So how about we get a little information first, Al, about where the show is?
Okay, the show will be held September 15th. At least that will be our show. Mm-hmm. And it will be held at McCungie Memorial Park in McCungie, Pennsylvania.
Okay.
Which is about 15 miles south of Allentown.
Okay, so it's this side of Allentown.
Yes.
For people in Reading, it's this side of Allentown.
Correct.
Right, right. And what time does the show start?
Probably about 8:30.
Oh, okay, okay. And it goes all day long?
Yes, till about 5-6 o'clock at night.
Okay, okay. Now, obedience is first thing in the morning, right?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
So that will go till...
Well, we have two rings going this year,
okay.
One for rally, one
okay.
for obedience.
Oh, okay.
They each should run about 5 to 6 hours long, starting at probably 8 or 8:30.
Okay, okay. So that's mid-afternoon?
Early, yeah, about 2 o'clock.
Right, right, right. Okay. Now, what is a point show? Well.
They're playing.
Well. The little one, the corgi is a puppy. She's only 4 months old. How old is Moose?
Mooch.
Sorry.
Mooch. He's big, but he's not a moose yet. Mooch will be 3 in October.
Oh, okay, okay. So we have a little girl dog who's
she's playing.
Showing off. Okay, so you want to tell me what a point show is?
Okay, a point show is a show that is sanctioned by the American Kennel Club, and only dogs that are registered with the AKC can show at this show. Based upon the winning as to your classes and things like that, you do accumulate points where you will get possibly a maximum of 5 points per show.
Mm-hmm.
And that will take, and then you will need 15 points to become a champion.
Okay, okay. So we could have some champions at this show as well?
We will have some champions okay. which have already have gotten their 15 points okay. at previous shows.
Okay. Why would you, if you're already a champion, why would you want to continue showing your dog?
Well, Mooch is actually a champion.
Okay.
And a grand champion.
Okay. What's a grand champion?
A grand champion is a dog that has already become a champion.
Uh-huh.
Continues to compete for more points.
Okay.
And to the next title, which is a grand champion.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't make the dog any better or any worse, but the dogs do enjoy being out and showing. They enjoy They enjoy being with people, and they're used to being on the go, and when you finish them and you leave them home, they get tired and bored, and a lot of people don't do obedience with their dogs.
Mm-hmm.
And this is just a way to keep them out, and they have fun and meet people and other dogs, and they get to socialize just like we do.
Very good. And there's different levels of grand champion?
There are, and there's silver and gold and bronze. I think bronze is first, then silver and gold.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Mooch just finished his grand, and we haven't shown him past that,
okay.
but he will be entered at the shows that weekend.
Oh, okay, good.
So we'll see if he adds and gets towards his bronze.
Now, is this the same 15 points that you have to get for a grand champion? Do you have to beat any other dogs? Or this is fairly new with the American Kennel Club, right? It was, what, maybe 2 years, 3 years?
Oh, it's more than...
It's about 2 years.
Yeah, I thought it was
Bocce, before Bocce went to Europe. But anyway... it's a few years old.
Uh-huh.
The dogs start out with their 15 points uh-huh. for their championship. Uh-huh. They need an additional 10 points.
Okay.
They need 25.
Okay.
They need to, oh, God bless you. They need to beat other champions at several shows.
Okay.
They have to win under different judges.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
They need majors, just like they do for their regular championship.
Okay. Now, majors. Somebody want to explain what majors are?
Okay, there are certain breeds. Well, these are all rulings set by AKC.
Okay.
Where there are, you need a certain amount of dogs to beat in order to become, to get these points.
Okay. So if now I don't have a real common breed, so for me to go in the ring against one other dog or two other dogs, I may get a point.
You must have a minimum of two dogs.
Okay.
To get 1 point.
Okay.
Now there are some breeds, your lesser known breeds, mm-hmm. where you can get a major is 3 points or more.
Okay.
It's either 3, 4, or 5 points.
Okay.
And like the lesser known breeds, you only need 4 dogs, mm-hmm. including yourself, to get at least a 3 point major.
Okay. Okay. Yep.
But then there are some like in Great Danes where you need like 38.
Yeah, yeah. And we're going to have a lot of Great Danes, aren't we?
As a matter of fact, we will be having 38,
38
of them this year.
I thought I saw that. Now we do have supported entries, don't we?
Yes, we do.
What are they?
The specialties are the Gordon Setters and the Keyshuns.
Okay. So there's many more of those. I think the Keysies, what are their 50 or some?
66.
Wow. So if you're interested in those little gray hairy dogs, you'll see lots of them at the show. Lots of them. What other, are there a lot of German Shepherds?
There's about 25 of the German Shepherds.
Do you know what our how many dogs are going to be there?
I would say approximately about 1,400.
Okay.
There will be a total of 148 different breeds.
Wow. Okay.
That are entered. Yeah. Now, some may or may not show up.
Yeah. Because I think I saw Leonbergers, but
yes.
There's also a miscellaneous.
Right.
There's not that many entered in the Catans.
There's only two.
The Catans. I think that's the only breed. The miscellaneous class is a class for dogs that aren't yet fully recognized by the American Kennel Club.
That's correct, and there's certain criteria that they have to have. They must have a number of entries at shows in order to become a fully recognized breed.
Right. Now, when we're talking about fully recognized AKC breeds, you're not going to see Labradoodles or Sheep Poos or Cockapoos or any of the other mixed breed dogs. These are only the purebreds that are recognized by the American Kennel Club. And the mixes are not purebreds, so they will not be there. They cannot show at our shows. We're trying to better the breed that we have, not mix it with something else. We know what problems we have in our breeds as far as medical problems. We know what to expect when we breed a Vizsla. We know with another Vizsla, we know they're going to be all red, they're going to look like this, and they're going to have flopped ears, and they're going to be good hunting dogs. The same with the corgis. When we breed a corgi to a corgi, we know what it's going to look like. When you breed a corgi to something else, you're not sure what you're going to get. So we know what we're going to get, and that's why only purebreds are being shown at this show. Judges. You don't have judges? Who has judges? Who knows anything about our judges?
We have lots of judges coming.
I know we have lots. And a lot of them are coming from a goodly distance. I'm not sure where the furthest is coming from. I didn't really check that out.
We have Missouri.
Okay.
Those are the two I can think.
New York, Rochester, New York.
Oh, well, that's close by. You know, that's driving distance.
Missouri's, we have a husband and wife coming from
Pittsburgh
area.
Okay. All right. So then we don't have really...
There's a couple coming from the south.
Okay. I mean, not from California, or because I think last year or the year before, we had one coming from California, or two coming from California. I just wanted to make sure. Now, if you don't want to know what's going on, anybody want to explain what a catalog is and how to read it? Kandy?
Oh, look at me.
don't look at you.
What a catalog, if you purchase a catalog at the show, it is going to show you all the different breeds of dogs, and they're going to be broken down into groups, and they will
every dog will have a number. It will list the dog's registered name, its AKC number, and the sire and dam, and the breeder and the owner of the dog. So if you come and purchase a catalog, in the front will be our whole
judging schedule.
I was going to say directory, judging schedule, as far as what time the breeds go in, and then you can look at that and figure out what dogs you want to see.
And what ring they'll be in and what time they're going to be on. So if you want to run from one ring to the next to see two different breeds, that'll be listed there in your catalog so you know where you're going at what time. We also have a list of, right in the front, we have a list of breeds that are being shown that day, too, as well, right? Isn't there a listing?
Yes.
That's alphabetically?
Yes.
Okay.
Pat, if I may, it also includes information on how to get in touch with the Kennel Club if you should want to join or come to any meetings.
Okay. Or call us in case you find a dog that you're, a breed of dog that you're really interested in. If you find a dog or you're coming to look at the dogs and you do have a catalog, you might want to call the Kennel Club and say, is there anybody in this area? You know, you see a breed and the owner is from Rochester. You don't want to run all the way up to Rochester to get the dog, so you might want to call the Kennel Club and say, hey, is there anybody with this breed of dog in this general area? We have an awful lot of very, very good breeders in this area of a number of different breeds of dogs. So, call the Kennel Club and see what's around before you go trekking off to Timbuktu to get a puppy. The classes. That's listed in the catalog as well, the different classes. Somebody want to tell us about the different classes, what we're going to see? If I go up to the ring and I see a whole mess of dogs, they're all standing outside the ring, waiting to go in, waiting for their turn, what should I be looking at?
The judges will judge the dogs. They will start with dogs first, males.
Okay.
And they will start with 6 to 9 months.
That's the earliest you can show a dog?
The dog must be 6 months of age. Now, AKC is starting something new with a 4 to 6 puppy special attraction.
Okay.
But that you must seek special permission to have.
Okay. But we're not having that.
But no, we are not.
Okay.
You have a 6 to 9 class, then you have a 9 to 12, 12 to 18, American bred, bred by exhibitor, novice, amateur owner handler, and open.
Okay. Now, obviously, the amateur owner handler is somebody who, this is their first dog?
It could be their first dog or even their first time in a ring. They may have given it to somebody else, a professional handler to show, but now they want to show.
Oh, okay. But if the dog's a champion, can they still go in amateur?
No, they cannot.
Okay. The dog can't have any, points?
The only class a champion can go into is the open class.
Okay.
And dogs can have points because the classes that I listed, those are the classes that you are eligible to get points in.
Okay. So once my dog wins this class, I have a 6 to 9 month puppy and he gets first place. What does that do for me other than get me a ribbon?
Okay, that will get you a nice blue ribbon, but we'll also make you eligible to go into the winner's class.
Okay.
Which is the first place of all the classes that I listed.
Okay, so that'd be the 6 to 9, the 9 to 12, 12 to 18, amateur, novice, bred by, and open?
And open.
So there's possibly 8 dogs that I'd be...
Well, it could be up to 9. There's...
Okay.
I think one class we missed.
Did we miss one class?
Well, I don't think so.
But...
Well, it doesn't really matter.
7, 8.
Yeah.
And then based on the number of total dogs, like total males entered, the winner of those 8 dogs in there will get points accordingly.
Okay. And then that's called the winner's dog.
Right.
Okay.
And then they do that with the females, then they do the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
And then at the very last thing then is your best of breed where your champions come in and your winner's dog and winner's bitch.
Okay. So they get a chance to get even more points?
That's correct.
Okay. So then if you're going, if I have winner's dog and I go in And there's like 8 other champions in the ring mm-hmm. with me. If I beat all of those and get best of breed, which is what I would be getting, right?
Exactly.
Would I get not only the points that I got in classes, but the points?
Correct.
Wow, that's pretty good. But I still can't get any more than 5, can I?
No.
Wow. Oh, well.
5's the limit. But it is not unknown to finish a dog, to get your 15 points in a weekend.
Wow. Okay. You have to have a pretty good dog.
With shows being 3-4 show weekends.
Mm-hmm. And that's what ours is, actually. Oh, we have to take a break, so we'll explain that when we come back.
You're watching All About Dogs on bctv.org. Be informed, be involved, be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For more information and other stories about animals and pets, go to www.bctv.org. All About Dogs is underwritten by the Berks County Kennel Club and by Berks Dog Training Club. For more information on how you and your business can become program underwriters, go to www.bctv.org.
So, what I was saying is that our show is now a cluster. And a cluster means a number of different clubs get together and hold shows on consecutive days. So, we have Pocono on Thursday and Friday. And these shows are all at the same place. And Saturday is Lehigh Valley, and then Sunday is Berks. And we are called, let me show you our beautiful ad. This is our ad in Dog News. And we are the Blue Mountain Cluster. So you can see all the shows, the Blue Mountain Cluster, September 12th through the 15th. And all of these shows are at the same place. So if you go to McCungee Memorial Park on Thursday or Friday or Saturday or Sunday, you will probably see most all the same dogs there. People just enter the cluster because you can take your motorhome or if you live close by and just, you know, stay there if you have a motorhome. There's some beautiful motorhomes. But you just stay at the grounds and show every single day. So, what else did I want to cover? So this is right on Route 100, right?
That's correct.
Okay.
You just go down or up 100, depends on which way you're coming from.
Okay.
And there will be a lovely banner hanging across Route 100, which will list the 3 clubs and in big letters, dog show.
Okay.
And you turn right there.
Yeah, right on Main Street.
That's correct.
Yeah, so it'll tell you which way to turn.
And I will say that there is free admission and free parking.
Oh, yeah, we forgot to mention that.
So it's a great day to spend at a show.
And they have food. We have food, and we have vendors. So no matter what you want for your dog, please leave your own dog at home. There's going to be, 1,400 dogs there. And if you're really interested in a specific breed, you're not going to be able to talk to a handler or, a person who breeds that type of dog and hold your own dog as well because your own dog, our dogs are used to being shown. They know to stand by your side and not do anything. So your dog is going to be ultra excited because there's so many dogs and so many people and so much stuff. So your dog is going to be all excited. You're going to have to control your dog as you're trying to talk to a person, and it just makes it a little unhandy. So leave your own dog at home if you're going to be coming to the show. It just is a much more enjoyable day for you. But the vendors, how many vendors are there? 13, 14?
We have about 22 of them.
22 vendors. So whatever you want as far as dog stuff, they have leashes and collars and toys and food and crates and
clothing
and clothing for the dog, clothing for you. What did I miss? Jewelry, antiques, artwork.
Anything with dog related.
That's exactly right. Anything with a dog on, you'll probably be able to find there. And a lot of things that you wouldn't be able to find at the pet stores here. They're catering to, the pet stores here are catering more to just regular pet dogs, but when you go to a show, a lot of us have like the leash that's on the little chin here. It's a very fine little black and white one. The leash that's on the little black and white one here. By the way, this is a Japanese chin. It's a special leash that you can only buy at a dog show. It's just for basically show dogs. It's a lightweight leash, and that's where we get our equipment. So if you're looking for something special or you're looking for unusual toys or bones, they have bones.
Handmade.
Handmade leashes?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you can get kangaroo hide leashes, just in case you are interested in a kangaroo leash. I'm not particularly one of those people, but anyhow, anything you want. The food is very good. They have lots of different vendors so that you can get whatever you want. Junior showmanship. What time are the juniors on? They're usually on in the afternoon, correct?
Usually afternoon.
Okay. Yes. This is the thing that your children might want to see. These are young children showing their own dogs. I think the youngest is, what, seven?
Nine,
okay. You can start showing when the child is 9 years old. He takes his own dog into the ring, and he shows his own dog. The dog is not judged. The child is judged. And it goes up to what, age 18?
17.
Okay.
Now, a junior can show, if they start out the year at 17, and turn 18, they could still continue showing, but then they age out, or what we call aging out.
Yeah.
When they become senior citizens.
Well, yeah, senior citizens at age 18, you know. But this is another class that if your child is really interested in dogs, it might be something that they would like to see and even possibly try, you know, come to a handling class and try. And what do we do with the proceeds of the show? What do we do with the proceeds of the show?
Part of the proceeds go to our annual scholarship fund.
Okay. And that's from all the schools in Berks County?
Yes.
Okay. And
to do is apply.
Apply. Okay. And I think the schools have that information already.
I believe they do.
Yeah, I think our scholarship chair already sent the forms out. So if you're interested in an animal-related, right?
Animal study, I think.
Some type of animal study that you're going on to college. Apply for our membership, because we do have two that received the scholarship this year. So and maybe they'll be at the show. I'm not quite sure. What else do I want to cover? I think that's about it. Oh, by the way, it is rain or shine, so we don't even think about rain. It's going to be a beautiful day, so
not too hot.
And not too hot, a nice breeze. Last year was absolutely gorgeous. But if you really are interested in so there you don't put your foot on me so if you're interested in seeing a lot of different breeds of dog, if you're interested in just seeing a specific breed of dog, if you're interested in getting something from one of the vendors, this is an excellent place to go. And considering it's free parking, admission, all you need to do is drive up to Mukunji, and it's really beautiful grounds. They're very, very nice grounds. One other thing before we close this evening, if you are bringing children, please do not let them touch the dogs until you ask the owners. Some of our dogs are not raised with children, so they don't know what these little things are. Don't let your child run up to a dog and grab it. And especially if that dog is ready to go in the ring. I know nice fluffy dogs are really exciting for young children. Please, please, please do not let them run up to the dog, especially if they've had something to drink or they're holding a soda in their hands. It's just, your child may get injured. So please, you know, make sure you ask someone about the dog if your child can touch the dog. That's the safe way to do it. So I don't think there's anything else we need to cover. Did I get everything? Anything any of you?
And I would say by Wednesday, maybe Thursday of this week, if they go to RAU, R-A-U, dogshows.com, the judging schedule will be up there so they can see what time their Any particular breed will be shown.
Okay. So if you actually are interested in Great Danes and you want to know what ring they're in and what time they're going to be shown, go to Rau Dog Shows, that's one word, RAUDOGSHOWS.com. And what is it, the judging program you go
the
into?
The judging program.
Go into
correct.
Judging program, and that will show you when the Great Danes are being shown, how many males, females, and you'll know what ring you're supposed to be going to at what time you're supposed to be going there. So that's also very helpful if you're interested in a particular breed. So that's our program for this evening. Hopefully we will see you on Sunday, September 15th. Anywhere from 8:30 to 4 o'clock in the afternoon, that's when probably Best in Show will be judged. So you can see all the dogs, you can spend all day long there, and we're going to have a beautiful day. So for this evening, good night.
Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.